Hey there, this is a video explaining how to configure Gnosis, the cast bar add-on, for the purposes of heroic Maloriak. If you're following this video, if you're following the link to this video from the thread I posted on my guild forums, then you may not actually understand why this is so essential, but the reason is that Arcane Storm is a 6-second cast and deals damage every 1 second. That means that every 1 second, Maloriak has a chance to absolutely murder us. On normal, it only does about 10,000-12,000 damage to the whole raid. On heroic, it deals about 40,000-50,000 damage to the whole raid, which is a ludicrous amount of damage and can very easily kill people in the various color phases because of, you know, just increased damage from things like Scorching Breath, Flash Freeze, and so on. And if it goes off even one tick in green phase, we take double damage, so that's about 80,000-100,000 damage to the entire raid. It's a pretty much a guaranteed wipe. So letting it through is basically not an option. You're almost guaranteed to not get a kill unless you can interrupt Arcane Storm 100% of the time without letting any tick through. So for this purpose, you'll want a mod like Gnosis. Gnosis is, as far as I'm aware, the only one that actually allows you to blacklist spells. Deadened used to work, but the various hooking modules that allowed Deadened to connect to things like Quartz and various unit frames haven't been updated in something like 2 years, so they're just hilariously out of date. Gnosis, on the other hand, is updated regularly and has the blacklisting function written directly into the code, so you don't need to rely on sort of a secondary mod to make your other mods work right. So I'm just going to quickly go into the configuration and show you how to set that up. So when you load Gnosis for the first time, you won't get this. It'll immediately unload in the game. You'll get a big dialog box in the middle of your screen saying, "Hi, welcome to Gnosis. Would you like to load a default configuration?" I recommend loading that default configuration and then setting it up however you want. If you're already using a mod like Quartz, I would recommend just turning it off and replacing it wholesale with Gnosis. Running two Castbar mods seems completely excessive to me, but whatever. Do as you please. The next time you load it, you won't actually have the ability to fiddle with your options until you hit this Create Options button. It just doesn't load them to save you a bit of memory. It's nice, but whatever. What you really want to do is you want to go in here and fiddle with the various options. So, just to show you what my personal setup is. So here we go. We have the focus over here. You probably don't want to fiddle with the focus, but then again, I don't know what you focus. I tend to focus not the boss, so it doesn't matter very much. So we can just hide that one. Likewise, I don't want to hide anything in my player setup, but hey, you never know. The one you're interested in is the target one down here on the right. What you want to do is, after you've configured it with all of the various settings, and there are quite a few you can fiddle with, I recommend personally right away changing the font, because the default font that Gnosis uses is hideous and incredibly difficult to read in a quick manner. What you're really interested, though, and the reason why you're looking at this configuration is for the hide castbar options. What you want to do is you want to go in here, down here to the fourth option. The first three are completely irrelevant, and you don't need to fiddle with them. Is you want to go in here and you want to hit blacklist. Now, once you've hit blacklist, you want to go into here and ignore this huge dialog over here on the right. It has a whole lot of configuration options that you can use, but they're completely superfluous to what we're doing, so don't worry about them. What you want to do is just type in release aberrations, and make sure that you're spelling aberrations right, because if you misspell it, like you only have one R, you add two B's or whatever, the game will not recognize it and will show you release aberrations anyway. After you've done that, make sure you hit accept, otherwise it will forget your configuration options. And that's about it. The other thing that I do that I find incredibly useful for this is that I have an extra one, you may have noticed it up here, called Arcane Storm. Arcane Storm is right here in the middle of my screen. It's pretty much impossible for me not to see that when I'm in the middle of DPSing. Arcane Storm is kind of like the target blacklisting option, only it's the sort of inverse. Instead of blacklisting, I use the whitelist option, which means that the only spells that will ever show up are the ones that I tell it to show up. So, in this case, I have Arcane Storm inserted. So again, type in Arcane Storm, hit accept, make sure it's big, it's visible, it's obnoxious, and you're good to go. Now what will happen is anytime Maloriak casts Release Aberrations, I won't see it in the target, and it won't show up here. When he casts Arcane Storm, though, it will show up in both, and I can start spamming Kick ASAP. There isn't really a whole lot else to say about it. If you have any questions, post a comment or respond to the thread. So, yeah, good luck. And don't wipe your raid.